Let us start with the chapter circles, and in today's class we are going to concentrate only on theorems. Now circle, how do you define circle? Anybody, can you tell me what is the definition of a circle? I'm drawing a geometrical figure, tell me what is that geometrical figure called? So this is point A and point B. What is this called? This is called a line segment. Do you know what is the difference between line segment and a segment?
Sir, I think a segment is a part that is covered between a line segment,
yes,
which is drawn inside a circle.
Okay, got it. Basically, line segment is one-dimensional figure. One dimension means we can represent this line segment with one dimension. Say, we can say length of segment AB is 5 centimeter. Am I right? This is 5 centimeter, but segment is a two-dimensional figure. Segment is a two-dimensional figure. We will talk about that later on. Why I am talking about a line segment? If I ask you what is the definition of line segment, so definition of line segment is that it is a set of infinite number of points. You can take it as small as possible, maybe 1 centimeter or even half centimeter. It is also a set of infinite points. Infinite points come together to form a line segment. Is it clear? And line segment has some length, as in this case of length 5 centimeter. So line segment is a set of infinite number of points. And circle is also infinite number of points. We can take infinite points on this circle. Infinite points come together to form a circle. But this definition, so there is no difference between a definition of a line segment and a definition of a circle. If we say that both are a set of infinite number of points, there is some additional condition in the definition of a circle. What is that additional condition? So definition of circle, circle is a set of infinite number of points whereby each point, there are infinite points, so every point, select any point, every point is at a fixed distance, at a fixed distance from a fixed point. So this is a definition of a circle. Circle is set of infinite number of points. Infinite number of points come together to form a circle in such a way that each point is at a fixed distance from a fixed point. Now this fixed distance is known as the radius. Fixed distance is defined as a radius. And can you guess what is fixed point known as? Fixed point is called the center. Alright, so this is a definition of a circle. Circle is a set of infinite number of points in which each and every point is at a fixed distance, is at a fixed distance. Let us say I take a point, this is center of a circle is P, and I take point M, and this distance, okay, this point M is at a distance say 3 centimeter from P. If I take another point, let us say M1, that is also at a distance of 3 centimeter from P. If I take next point M2, that is also at a distance of 3 centimeter for P, and this rule is applicable for each and every point of a circle, and this fixed distance is called the radius. And this fixed point from where we are measuring the distance of a point on the circle, that fixed point is called a center. So when we define circle, we also define center and a radius of a circle. Is it fine? Now look at this first diagram. I think we already have defined radius and a center. Now what is a diameter? Okay, before understanding the diameter, we will talk about a chord. Now this is a line segment. We just spoke about it. Line segment A and B. Now I am drawing this line segment on a circle. I am drawing this line segment in such a way that both the end points lie on a circle. Okay, this is line segment AB. A is a point on the circumference of a circle. B is also a point on the circumference of a circle. So this is called a chord of a circle. Now tell me, in a circle, how many chords can be drawn? If this is a circle, how many chords can be drawn? Definitely infinite. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. And if you are not satisfied, you can go this way also. There are so many ways in which you can draw a chord. Now you must have noticed one thing, ki as you go closer to the center of the circle, this is the center of a circle and this center is generally denoted as O or P. If you are trying to go close to this center, you will see that length of the chord goes on increasing. And you get a biggest chord or a longest chord of a circle when it passes through center of a circle. You get a biggest chord in a circle when your chord is passing through the center of the circle. And if you continue drawing a chord, you will see that you are going away from the center and again your chord is becoming smaller and smaller. This brings me to a conclusion that diameter is the largest or longest. Correct word must be longest, is the longest chord of a circle. So what we have seen till now is the definition of a circle. Circle is a set of infinite number of points in which each and every point is at a fixed distance from a fixed point. Fixed point is called a center. Fixed distance is called a radius. After understanding center and radius, chord is a line segment whose both the endpoints lies on the circle. And in a circle, diameter is the longest chord. Diameter is also defined as a chord which passes through center of a circle. From this definition, we can derive one formula. If this is a radius of a circle and this is also a radius of a circle, surely this diameter is made up of what? 2 radii. So diameter of a circle is twice the radius. So this is the formula which we are going to use while solving the numerical. Now let us talk about a line with respect to a circle. This is a line and this is a circle. Now when this line is passing like this, this line have no connection whatsoever with this circle. But you can see that I'll name this as line 1, L1, and this as line 2. L1 intersect this circle at 2 points. And L2 intersect this circle at a single point. So the line which intersect this circle at 2 points, that line is called a secant. Remember this, later on we are going to have a theorem related to this secant also. Towards the third and fourth part of the chapter. So this line which intersect this circle at 2 points is called a secant. And the line which intersects the circle at just single point, at one point, is called a tangent. And since this line intersects the circle at one point or a single point, this point is a special point. It is given a special name. It is called point of contact. It is called point of contact. Or even you can say that this is point of tangency. And generally it is represented by T. Okay, most of the time this point is represented by T. So to repeat again, L1 is a line which intersects the circle in 2 points. When a line intersects a circle and in 2 points, that line is called a secant. And line L2 intersects the circle. We don't use a word intersect when it is a tangent. We say line touches the circle, okay? When it intersects the circle, when a line intersects the circle at a single point, that is not called as an intersection, that is called touching the circle. So when a line is touching a circle, then that line is called a tangent, and that point where line touches the circle, that is called point of contact or point of tangency. Alright, any doubt so far? Are you okay with the definition of a circle? Are you okay with the definition of center, radius, diameter, secant, chord, tangent, and point of contact? Because these are the words which we are going to use frequently. So coming here, most of the things we were talking about, they were all one dimension. They have only single unit. We can express them in terms of centimeter. Now look at this part. Suppose we have a chord like this, a chord. Now it divides a circular region. When I say region, I am talking about two dimensions. So this chord divides a circle into two regions. Look at this part, this region. Is it visible or should I use different color?
Yes, if it is, it's visible.
Okay, fine. So this region, okay, it is a region, so we can find out area of this region. So this region is called a segment. This is line segment. Don't make a mistake here. This is a line segment and this is called a segment as written over here. This is called a segment. All right. We have a theorem related to segment also. We are not doing any faltu ka bakwas over here or wasting our time. Whatever we are going to study in future, we are just trying to create a base for that. So again, I'll shade this part or this region, a two-dimensional region. You can find out area of a segment also. In mensuration, you find out area of a segment, but that part is not included in your syllabus. So this region, which does not include the center of a circle, when I was shading this region, this segment, it does not include the center of a circle. So this segment is called a minor segment. In our day-to-day life, minor is that child which is below the age of 18. You all are minors. And if you once you pass your 18th birthday, then you are no more minor. Okay? Now guess the other region. This region which includes the center of the circle. What is this region called? Again a two-dimension. You can find out area. Obviously, if this is major, then if this is minor, the other region which includes the center of the circle is called the major segment. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
And minor segment and major segment are called alternate segments. Please focus here because we have a theorem related to angles in the alternate segment and students fail to understand this. Because they cannot visualize, okay, वो दो area, minor segment और major segment को, they fail to visualize this, okay, एक angle जो होगा, वो इधर होगा, और दूसरा वाला angle major segment में होगा. So please, don't ignore this part, this is very, very important, okay. So if you draw a chord of a circle, and that chord is not a diameter, why not a diameter? Because diameter, what do you think? Diameter divide this circle into two region. Each region is called what? What is this region called?
Segment.
No, yes, this is segment, but isn't it a semicircle? Half circle. So diameter divides a circle into two semicircles. Suppose if you draw two radii, this is the center of a circle, this is first radius and this is the second radius. So the region between these two radii is called the sector. Unfortunately, we don't have a theorem related to this sector. About this sector, you will be studying in mensuration. And a sector smaller than the semicircle is the minor sector. And the remaining half, okay, is the major sector. It is like this is a cake, your birthday cake, and you cut a small part of it. But thing is that you have to cut it right from the center. That pie or that part which you have cut, that is called the sector. So smaller than a semicircle is the minor sector, and the region or the sector which is bigger than the semicircle is called the major sector. And you can afford to ignore this sector, but everything else is very, very important, okay? Finally, one last definition, arc of a circle. Take a part of a circle, that is called a arc of a circle. Now, if you see a bangle, glass bangle, you have a poem, na, bangle seller. So, when that bangle breaks, so this part, one part of a circle, okay, this part of a circle is a arc of a circle. But I hope you have understood all these terms. Circle, radius, diameter, chord, secant, tangent, center, segment. Okay. If you have understood this, we are all set to start with theorem number 1.